And all of this can be put together in a single paragraph that was brought by Imam Ahmad in his Ar-Rad al-Jahmiya wal-Zanadiqa. On page number 2, in the beginning of the book, he mentions Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. The book Ar-Rad al-Jahmiya, a refutation of the followers of Jahm ibn Safwan, the one who was executed in the year 124 for his innovation and for denying the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in totality. And the Zanadiqa, the heretics in the religion, those who introduce matters into the religion to cause corruption within it. So Imam Ahmad says, all praise is due to Allah, who in every age and every interval between the prophets raises up a group from the people of knowledge, who call the misguided to guidance, and they patiently bear ill treatment and harm that comes upon them, the people of knowledge. With the book of Allah they give life to the dead, by Allah's light they give sight to the blind. This is what the scholars do. With the book of Allah they give life to the dead, because they give life to the heart that dies, and by the light of Allah they give sight to the ones who are blind. Because verily all of us are blind, and all of our hearts were dead, or many of our hearts were dead, up until we realized what Islam and the Sunnah, what it meant. So we made our hearts inclined towards Allah, and we gave our sincerity towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we made a conscious decision to follow the Sunnah of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And many of us remain sincere upon that, knowing that no matter how hard the Sunnah becomes, we will be with the Sunnah wherever we go. No matter what comes to us, whether it means that we have to leave our fathers, our wives, our children, we will leave them for the sake of Allah. We will leave them for the sake of Allah. This is the life that Allah puts into the hearts of mankind, when the hearts are dead and Allah gives them life. How? By the use of the scholars. And by Allah's light, they give light, they give sight to the blind. How many a person killed by Iblis, Imam Ahmad said, how many a person killed by Iblis have they revived? How many people astray and wandering have they guided? How beautiful have their effect been upon the people? And how vile have the people been towards them? Towards who? Towards the scholars of Al-Islam. These scholars of Al-Islam, they expel from the book of Allah the tahrif of the ghaleen, of those going beyond the bounds. They expel from the book of Allah and the religion the alterations of those going beyond bounds, and the false claims of the liars, and the false interpretation of the ignorant ones. This is tasfiyah, ya ikhwan wa akhawat, this is tasfiyah. This is purifying the religion. They expel from the book of Allah the alterations of those going beyond bounds. This is tasfiyah, to purify the religion from that which is not from it. The false claims of the liars, those who lie upon the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they lie upon the Sahaba, and they lie upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these scholars of Al-Islam, they perform this tasfiyah and the false interpretation of the ignorant ones. That the one who can speak, he speaks only because Allah has put a tongue into his mouth, so he decides that he's got to speak, just because he has a mouth to speak. So the ignorant ones, they start speaking. So when they speak, they oppose the deen. And they don't know the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَا تَقْوَ لَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ إِلْمِ. Do not pursue of that which you have no knowledge. But they speak without knowledge about the deen of Allah. So the scholars Allah raises in every age and every era to purify the religion from that which is other than the religion. And those innovators who uphold the banner of innovation, that they purify the religion from them. And these innovators who let loose the trials, the fitna, and they cause separation and discord, and they differ about the book of Allah, and they oppose the book of Allah, and they agree and they make an agreement to oppose the book of Allah. They speak about Allah and His book without knowledge. and they argue about the book, that part of it which is ambiguous, and they deceive the people with ambiguity. The scholars, they are the ones who Allah raises to protect the people from this. So we seek refuge in Allah from the trials of the misguided ones. These are the words of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. And we know this to be a reality in our time. We know this to be a reality in our time. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that verily Allah does not remove the knowledge, but stripping it from the hearts of the people. But rather Allah removes the knowledge by the death of the ulama. So much so, that none of them remain. And then the people take their ignorant ones as their leaders. So these ignorant ones, they lead the people astray and they lead themselves astray. They issue fatwa and ruling, leading themselves astray and leading the people astray. And this is the reality of the situation of the earth today, of the ummah today. That the scholars are passing away. And those who remain after the scholars, that the people start destroying them and dishonoring them. So they speak ill of the major scholars, because they're few in number in our time. Not like the time of the Salaf. Not like the time of the companions. Imagine in the time of the companions, as Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen mentioned, 114,000 companions of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At the time of his death, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 114,000 imams for us. A'imma. All of them imams for us, an example for us to be followed. After that time, the tabi'un, increasing in number,